Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back. It is I, Mythical Misfortune, with a confirmation on one of my theories. Theory being the first Owari No Seraph Theory. Now, for those of you who didn't watch it, I'm going to post the link right up here in the upper right corner so you can go watch it. But I'm also going to summarize it right here, right now. So in this first Owari No Seraph Theory, I theorized that you, our main character, would become a hybrid a vampire, demon, and angel, or half vampire, half Nephilim, depending on how you want to look at it. Now, this is where I'll also suggest spoilers, and if you want to walk away now, you can, because all of what I'm about to talk about is non-anime created. It's all been shown in the manga, so if you don't want to hear this, click away from the video now. Look at your computer. Look at the side of your YouTube videos. Maybe you see other fine Data Squad videos. Maybe you see some Dishonored that we just did. Maybe you see something else. Maybe you see another anime review from me. Maybe you're seeing Final Fantasy 15. Not? Sorry, a little bit too early for that. Anyways, here we go. So in the latest chapter of Owari No Seraph, we see Freed Bathory and Cruel Tempest being judged in front of the second Prognator and the newly promoted third Prognator that was the fourth Prognator before Cruel was captured, because she was captured by Free, as we all know, through season 2, and the vampires are judging them because of the fact through her being captured and shown as a traitor, blah blah blah, by other vampires. The capital of the kingdom for Japan, because Cruel was queen there. She now has to be punished because that capital was taken over by humans, as Freedwood has to as well, being a seventh Prognator. So we see them get captured, handcuffed by other vampires, and then apparently we find out that there is a special ring that all vampires use to protect them from the sun, in which it can be broken at any moment in time for them to feel the effects of the sun. So that's one confirmation about them being more natural vampires, rather than they can just do whatever the hell they want. They have special equipment infused with maybe some magic and some other things to help protect them from the sun. But in this, we find out that Yu and his squad want to save Freed, as much as Yu doesn't really trust Freed right now, with everything, of course, it's only natural. He still wants to help him, because we also find out in an earlier chapter before that Freed has his entire family that he killed with their heads, and finds out that he can revive them by using another Sephira of the End. But you also find out that you technically can't directly use a Sephira of the End to bring him back to life, because you'll cause the end of the world for the second time, or an even worse disease, because as we also find out, Guren is the one that caused the end of the world that happened at the beginning of the anime series, or the series overall. They also caused the disease and everything else that wiped out half of humanity, all to save his own squad that is currently with him. He used the Sephira of the End to bring them to life. So Freed has suggested to Yu and his group that he can bring back the rest of Yu and Mika's family through the same means, while also not having the same results. So it is for these reasons that you and everybody else decide that they want to save Freed and Cruel, because they also came there to save Cruel initially. So we have Crowley, who's with them on the bus, semi-protecting them, and suggests that, well, if you really want to save them, you're going to have to train that angel inside of you. Therein lies the entire thing right there. Crowley suggests that there is a way to train the angel inside of you to where he can use it properly. It becomes part of himself, just like his demon. So with that, we're essentially going to soon see you as a hybrid angel and demon. And I still feel like that vampire thing is coming. It's just going to happen. Yu's going to get like some severe injury, and he is going to become part vampire because Mika's going to want to save his life. And that right there in itself is what's going to give us the new, I guess, Ichigo effect. And a vampire, demon, angel, or vampire Nephilim mix. We can only wait and see how exactly you will train his angel to be able to control it. Or, however, if it becomes part of him to where he can fully control it in that sense in the next chapter coming here in December. And that's all I have for you today, guys. Let me know in the comments below what you think of this major revelation. Or if you just like, I'll wait till a little bit later. Or if you want to find out about something else, or if you want another theory. Let me know in the comments below, guys. And as always, until next time, I'll see you next time. Have a God-blessed day.